On today's internet, there's thousands of programming courses. So just how do you know that the person who's put that course together, the instructor, is someone who actually knows what they're talking about and can actually lead you on your journey to becoming a software developer? Let's talk about how to do that in today's video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And we're talking about just how you can figure out if a particular person has the skills as an instructor to pass on to you to help you in your quest to become a software developer. Well, first and foremost, check the credentials of that instructor. And what I'm talking about is not looking at the video, the sales video, or looking at the sales page, and not looking at the testimonials on those pages, because those pages generally have got the best case scenario. So they'll give you a bit of information about the course, and they'll say how good they are and how great the course is, etc. And perhaps, you know, the person who's most happiest with the course leaves a testimonial, they put it on there. But that doesn't really give you enough information, in my opinion, to make a decision. Firstly, I would check is to make sure that they've actually got credentials in, by that I mean, real world commercial programming experience. Very important to have done this for a living as a commercial developer. If your instructor, the person who's put together this course that you're looking to take, has no commercial programming experience, then really how can they hope to teach you the skills that you need to get a job commercially and to actually program commercially? Unfortunately, the reality is there's a lot of marketers out there today. Marketers, I mean, is people who are trying to make a quick dollar. They put something together that they hope will be worthy of someone wanting to buy it, but they've got no idea whether it's correct, whether it teaches best industry practices, and whether it's suitable really to help someone, to help teach someone how to program is what I'm trying to say. The best way to make sure that happens is firstly to make sure that this person is a programmer. Pretty basic, but if you're wanting to learn how to program, make sure you learn from a programmer. So they need to have real world commercial programming experience, and I would say a substantial number of years of commercial programming experience, at least a couple of years at the barest minimum. That's number one, so make sure they've got some experience. But secondly, this is a lot easier for you to check, is just to go and read the reviews. I know that this is probably an easy thing, but go and read the reviews left by real people who have left reviews on this particular instructor's courses in the past. Not necessarily the course you're looking at, but another course, even some of their earlier courses, and try and get a pattern and see if there's a pattern there on their teaching techniques. Now, obvious things are here, if there's a lot of negative reviews and very few positive reviews, then that's already a red flag. But more than just that, I suggest you go through and read the comments. What do students love about this instructor's course? In other words, what do they get the most out of? What do they think that this instructor has done best and done things right and most? But also, what do they dislike about it? What's the things that they, in their opinion, they felt that the instructor didn't do properly? And try and get a general overview from a number of different students. So don't just read one negative review. Look, I can tell you right now that there's always going to be someone who absolutely hates someone's content for whatever reason. And that applies to most things in life. Some people will love something. A lot of people will just think, yeah, it's all right. And some people will hate something. That's just the reality of being a human. So don't just read one or two reviews to form your opinion. Try and get a diverse range of views. So you might want to read 20 or 30 reviews and see if there's a pattern emerging. And if you read 20 or 30 reviews and it's constantly glowing and everything is exactly the same and they've just got all 5-star reviews, maybe that's a sign. Maybe that's a bad sign. Bad sign in the sense that, are they fake reviews? You are going to find that in any programming course of substance, you're going to find people who love it, as I said before, people who think on the fence about it, and people who hate it. But it's what the majority of people think about the course. That should be what you're formulating your opinion on. So if overall, I say 80% or 90% of the people are giving it 5-star reviews and absolutely love it, and there's a good reason why they love it. They think it's teaching them and they've learnt a lot from it, and they've got a lot out of the course, that's a sign that you found a good instructor. And the best thing you could do is try and find reviews where the person has said that they've used the content and they've gone on to get their first programming job. That would really, to me, be like a no-brainer. That'd be a tick to say, I found the great, the right instructor for that. So there are two things that you can do. Check the credibility of the lecturer. Make sure that they're not just a marketer, that they are a programmer. They've got teaching experience, but also check the reviews to make sure that to other people who've been through the course, either the course you're looking to buy or another course by that instructor, are happy with the material, get a gauge for that, and that'll put you in the greatest position to be be fairly sure, you know, nothing's 100%, but be fairly sure that this instructor is the right one for you. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left-hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here and I'll see you soon.